Dear students, in this session we will discuss upon communication and computer networks. Communication means to convey a message, an idea, a picture or a speech that is received and understood clearly and correctly by the person for whom it is conveyed. And a system consisting of carriers and related devices used to transport the data or idea or picture or speech from one point to another is termed as data communication system. So, various communication devices, principles are used to establish a communication data, to establish a data communication system. So, number one is transmission media. Media is a general term used to describe the data path that forms the physical channel between sender and the receiver. Transmission media can be either guided or unguided. Guided media. The guided media refers to the method of transmission of data over which signals can travel in a network. These may be twisted pair cable or coaxial cable or optical fibers. The optical fibers may be either in the form of light emitting diodes, popularly or in short called LEDs, or in the form of light amplification by stimulated emission radiation, in short or popularly we call it laser rays. So, these are the media under guided media. The unguided media, media in which the signals are not guided through a solid medium are known as unguided media, and air is the media through which electromagnetic energy can flow easily. As for example, radio waves, microwave transmission, light wave transmission, etc. So, these are the media used in communication system. The another device or the technology known as multiplexing. So, multiplexing is the method of dividing a communication channel into many logical channels so that a number of independent signals may be simultaneously transmitted on it. The electronic device that performs this task is known as multiplexer. The multiplexer brings together several low speed communication lines, transform into one high speed channel and reverses the operation at other end. There are three basic methods to multiplex channels. Number one is frequency division multiplexing, that is FDM. Time division multiplexing, TDM, and the third one, that is wavelength division multiplexing, that is WDM. The another required technique is switching. In networking, switching is a technique that decides the best path on which to send the data so that it can reach its destination in minimum amount of time. Such nodes form a switch network. Two most common forms are circuit switching and packet switching. Circuit switching. First, we should know what is circuit. A route between certain limits or boundaries is termed as circuit. In communication, circuit switching usually refers to the establishment of a connection in which the data path is fixed in time and space, or The path remains fixed until the circuit is disconnected. Packet switching. Packet switching derives from its name from the way a message is split into many segments or packets, each of which is handled as a separate communication. The one important terminology is often used, that is node. So, we should know what is node. Node is an endpoint of a branch in a network or a common junction of two or more network branches. Now, let's take a look on computer network. An interconnection of computer system and or peripheral devices with carriers and data communication devices for the purpose of exchanging data and information is called computer network. Thus, or we may say, computer networking reduces both cost and time in transferring data or information. Various topology are used to connect the computer and peripheral devices with each other. So, topology is defined as, it is a method in which networks are physically connected together. There are various topologies available. The number one, that is, or we may talk initially, that is bus topology. In linear bus topology, all computers are connected by a single length of cable with terminator at each end. It is a passive topology, which means all one computer at a time can send a message. Therefore, the number of computers attached to a bus network can significantly affect the speed of the network. The another topology, which is ring topology. Layout of ring topology is similar to the linear bus, except that the nodes are connected in a circle using cable segment. In it, each node is physically connected to only two other nodes. Each node passes information along the next until it arrives at the intended destination. Another topology which are in use, that is star topology. In a star topology, each computer communicates with a central hub that resends the message either to all computers in a broadcast star network or only to the destination computer in switched star network. So, what is hub? We should know. Hub, it is a network device where the information flow is accumulated and then distributed to various groups and users. We may say hubs are devices that serve as the central point where cables from all nodes come together. Active hubs function as repeaters, while passive hubs simply pass on signals. The one of the most prominent topology and familiar and upon which the internet is based, that is mesh topology. There is no defined connectivity as in bus, ring or star topology. Several devices are used in this topology. Its prominent and most common example is internet. Now we talk about the layout and connectivity of the computers, and next we will discuss on the methodology, which is termed as protocols. So, communication protocol. The term protocol means the set of rules or standards designed to enable computers to be connected with one another and to exchange information among them with very little error or no error. The protocol generally accepted for standardizing over all computer communications is a 7-layer set of hardware and software guidelines, which is known as OSI, Open System Interconnection Model. Thus, the word protocol is used in reference to a multitude of standards affecting different aspects of communication. Some prominent protocols are TCP/IP, Transmission Control Protocol, and Internet Protocol. It is a suite that an application can use to package its information for sending across the network or networks. TCP and IP also refers to an entire collection of protocols called protocol suite. This suite lets communication occur between heterogeneous means dissimilar networks that are connected. The another one, that is IP, Internet Protocol. IP provides the basic mechanism for forwarding of data between two computers on separate networks. IP can also fragment packets if they are too large to forward for some other networks. Another protocol known as ARP, I mean Address Resolution Protocol. When an IP has a packet in communication, the packets are termed as datagram. So, to send, IP must also inform the Network Access Protocol, NAP, such as Ethernet, which is a topology, of the destination's hardware address. If IP does not have the hardware address, it uses the AR, I mean Address Resolution Protocol, to find it this information. ARP, I mean Address Resolution Protocol, also act as an IP detective. Another one, that is Reverse Address Resolution Protocol, RARP. When an IP address machine happens to be diskless machine, it has no way of initially knowing its IP address, but it knows the MAC, I mean Media Access Control, MAC address, and a request to be informed of what IP address is assigned to its MAC address. The another one, that is, or we may say that was, this has been obsolete, SLIP, Serial Line Internet Protocol. This was initially developed for Unix environment that supports TCP/IP networking over a serial transmission lines which are connected by modem. And nowadays it has become obsolete and replaced with point-to-point, I mean PPP protocol. So PPP, point-to-point protocol, it provides router-to-router and host-to-network connection over synchronous and asynchronous circuits. PPP frames can be transmitted over a serial transmission line, such as old telephone services, PSTN, I mean public switched telephone networks, and ISDN, integrated service digital networks. It includes LCP, link control protocol, for establishing testing wide area network connections and performing modification in network communications. So, these rules and regulations, I mean protocols, are used in establishing communication system. Some devices which are used, so some of them are here. Adapters, it is a network adapter installed in computers that enable them to communicate on a network. Antenna, you know, the part of transmitting or receiving system that is designed to radiate or to receive electromagnetic waves is called antenna. ATM switch, a synchronous transmission mode, ATM. A device that controls information traffic between PCs or workstations using high speed links. Bridge, a device that supports LAN, local area network, to LAN, another local area network communications. This device bridges two different network segments regardless of their routing or what topology they have used. Gateway, a device that is used to interface two otherwise incompatible network facilities. A gateway is a combination of hardware and software with its own processor and memory used to perform protocol conversions. So bridges are used to connect LAN to LAN, whereas gateway are used to connect dissimilar network, I mean LAN to LAN, LAN to WAN, etc. Router, the most common device. A device that interconnects two or more physically and logically separate network segments and operates at the network layer of OSI, reference model. Hub, just we have discussed. So it is a network device where the information flow is accumulated and then distributed to various groups and users. Modem. Modem stands for modulator demodulator. Modem converts analog signal to discrete and vice versa. That is, modem converts communication signals from a form to computer can understand to a form the telephone system can convey and vice versa. Multiplexer, a device that brings together several data communication lines or signals, transforms them into one data communication line and reverses the operation at the other end. Network interface card. In short, we call it NIC. It is a board that provides network communication capabilities for a computer system. Server, you all know. The main high capacity computer where all information is stored. A system that shares resources with one or more workstation on a network. Socket, you often use in your house, everywhere. A bidirectional pipe for incoming and outgoing data that enables an application program to access the TCP/IP protocol, that is socket. Switch constantly monitor the traffic that across them and route their internal connections automatically to provide the most efficient operation for the network. VSAT, it is short form of very short aperture terminal. It can be described technically as an intelligent earth station connected to geosynchronous satellite suitable for supporting a variety of two-way telecommunication and information services such as voice, data and video. So with the help of these devices, these protocols, these media, these topology, we establish the communication network. So this is all about this session. Okay, thanks.